Over the course of time, the EPA has overreached. And a great example of this is when they proposed a rule that would allow the EPA to come onto farmers' lands and dictate to them how they manage the water on that land. Now, Bruce Braley supported that overreach with the EPA because he is being backed by California environmentalist Tom Steyer. He stood with the EPA over our Iowa farmers.
That's not true. I voted to prohibit the EPA from regulating ditches and farm ponds, and Senator Ernst knows that. You're saying that you don't want anyone making sure that the air we breathe is clean, the water we drink is pure. Those words have consequences that are harmful to Iowans. And Senator Ernst knows that, and that's why she's supported by the Koch brothers and big oil backers who want to get rid of those rules.
I don't see how this is affordable for anyone. When the President and Congressman Braley promised us that we would see an average reduction of $2,600 per family, families are paying more and they've lost their coverage.
Yet 47 million Americans didn't have health insurance coverage before the Affordable Care Act was passed. I've worked with Governor Branstad to make sure that 100,000 Iowans who didn't have access to health care have it now. And that's a good thing. And we need to fix what's wrong with the Affordable Care Act and improve it. But we can't go back to the days when people were getting kicked off of health care coverage for no reason.
I will always fight to protect Social Security and Medicare for our seniors like my parents. This is a very important issue because over 600,000 Iowans rely on Social Security. And this is a promise that has been made to those retirees and those that are nearing retirement. But we have to face the fact that Social Security is running out of funds. And within the next 20 years, if we don't do something, our retirees will see a 25% decrease in their monthly payments. But what we have to do now is look long-term and preserve Social Security for our children and grandchildren. So we have to look at many different options that are available out there. And I'm willing to look at all of those different options to find a solution, except for raising the retirement age.
Look, sound bites have consequences. And Senator Ernst has said that she will keep her promises to seniors. And yet, when you consider privatizing Social Security and turning those investments over to risky Wall Street investment bankers, that is not protecting Social Security. So there's a very big difference between us on this issue. And I also think that you need to look at ways that you can put more revenue into Social Security through other means, by expanding the economy, investing in infrastructure and rebuilding our manufacturing base. And yes, increasing the minimum wage, which I support, would put billions annually into the Social Security Trust Fund.
Raising the minimum wage is not an answer. If we raise the minimum wage, we're looking at job losses, 500,000 potential job losses across the United States, 20,000 here in the state of Iowa.
I heard an ad today, Congressman Braley, the NRA Political Victory Fund, insinuating that you and Michael Bloomberg are buddies now and that you're going to take away my Second Amendment rights, and I don't like it. So what's the answer?
The answer is, I've never met Michael Bloomberg. So Senator Ernst is fond of saying things that sound good, but when you look at what they mean to Iowans, they don't make Iowans better off. And this is another example of that. You can't say that you stand with farmers and say, I'll vote against the farm bill, that you're not a strong supporter of the renewable fuel standard because you don't agree with it in principle. And these are things that have consequences for Iowans.
Yes, when it comes to words and actions, actions speak louder than words. And I have a 100% rating when it comes to renewable fuels. That's from the Iowa Renewable Fuels Association. I will continue to stand up for farmers and rules. Now, I think it's very important to have farmers in the United States Senate. When you talk about your words behind closed doors at a fundraiser in Texas, you poked fun at Senator Grassley for being just a farmer without a law degree. And And you have said, Congressman, that you would fight against tort reform, which is driving health care costs up for our most vulnerable Americans.
Well, there's been a direct attack. There's been applause. I think, Gary, that I should have an opportunity to respond.
30 seconds. Please go ahead.
I have supported farmers in the United States Congress by voting twice to pass a five-year farm bill. I worked 3 years to pass the last one. And I've been an outspoken champion for the renewable fuel standard. My support is strong, clear, and unequivocal, and that's why I received the endorsement of the Iowa corn growers, and that's why the National Farmers Union supports me.
Did you, Joni Ernst, sign a pledge with the Koch brothers?
No, I have not. No, I have not signed a pledge with the Koch brothers. And again, this is so much misinformation that's coming from Harry Reid's Senate Majority PAC, from extreme environmentalist Tom Steyer from California, and coming from the congressman's own campaign. I have not signed a pledge with the Koch brothers. And matter of fact, I have been outspent from outside money coming into the state of Iowa by about $2 million.
Well, I think, Senator Ernst, you have signed pledges. You've signed pledges with a group called Club for Growth. And the truth is you attended two secret donor meetings in California that were hosted by the Koch brothers. You called them wonderful at that meeting. You credited them with launching your Senate campaign. And these are the same Koch brothers who have seven different organizations attacking me right now in Iowa. Seven.
Again, this is from someone that's being supported by a California billionaire extreme environmentalist who opposes the Keystone Pipeline, which then the congressman flip-flopped on that issue. So, yes, I have signed a taxpayer protection pledge so that anybody that is paying taxes can keep more of those dollars in their pockets. I support those hardworking Iowa families out there that wish to make the decisions what to do with their own money.
People running for office keep telling how they are going to help the middle class. What is the middle class?
I am the middle class. My husband, Gail, was laid off of his second shift job at a factory a number of years ago, and we were very fortunate. He did find another job. I live in a middle-class neighborhood. My husband and I bought our house for $80,000 in Red Oak, Iowa. It was a home that belonged to one of my childhood friends, and we still live there today. It's an average neighborhood. It is perfect Iowa out there.
William, the middle class is the heart and soul of America. And it used to be policies were designed to strengthen and expand the middle class. That's why I started a caucus when I was first elected to Congress, to focus on economic policies that will strengthen and expand access to the middle class. That's what the American dream is all about.